Regarding the title this year's conference is the state under deconstruction. How do you see the role of state in modern diplomacy, especially in resolving a crisis?
Well, I think we have posed ourselves and to the participant speakers and everybody who was attending Belgrade Security Forum a huge question, and we have raised so many additional questions in regard to the title of the conference, not really providing a lot of the answers. But I think the main axis is that the state, of course, is and still is and will be very important for the global security community building, that there are a lot of challenges that are non-state origin, and that there is maybe an axis of future development that will be crucial for determining the role of state. And this is the axis of state and individual. A citizen, a civic, member of any of the country, and this is something that is going into different directions and developments, and this is something that will be crucial in determining the role, the future roles and changes that the state will undergo, definitely.
Again, is the Balkans on the road from conflict zone to security community?
Well, I like to believe that also organizing this event and everything that we are talking about at the Balkan Security Forum is kind of a proof that we are becoming more of a contributor to the solving the issues and the problems of the global security, European, regional, not only regional but even in the wider context, and that we are not so much and anymore the object of the global security and someone who is creating a problem, but someone who has the capacity to some extent, not exaggerating our role, as I said, to contribute to the possible solutions and to provide different opinions and views on how many issues can be resolved, having in mind also the difficult problems we had in the past.
Again, what are your impressions on Third Balkan Security?
Well, I think it's an excellent event, becoming a kind of tradition that everybody has on the map. Not only the local actors, decision makers, policy makers, civil society, academic community, media, but also even the wider European and global community has it as a relevant policy venue where you can really engage into constructive debate and discussion. This is something that we have been tended for and looking for. I also think this is a very important exercise for the entire Balkans, not only Serbia, in preparing ourselves for the EU membership. As I said, not only because it is a process that is crucial for modernization of our countries, democratization of the countries, but because it is a process that requires a responsible and active member of the global community, European community. And the Belgrade Security Forum has been instrumental in this respect as well.
Ken, what are the plans for the next Belgrade Security Forum?
To be better, we are like European Union, learning from our mistakes and trying to improve the things that had not functioned so perfectly as we envisaged. So we will definitely improve some aspects. We will keep the trademarks, as I said, especially this human security approach that is cherished by three civil society organizations who are organizers. But we will also look upon the challenges that will mark the following year, that were mentioned also during the discussions. That is also the anniversary of 100 years since the beginning of the First World War, and how the things are changing and have changed in this past century, and also some other global and European issues like European Parliament, future of the European Union, and thus of the Balkans in this context.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.